Hey everyone, it's CR7 here, and welcome to this week's post-race thoughts and recap video of the playoff race from Kansas. And there was a lot of playoff drivers who had problems today. So, without further ado, I have my race notes with me, of course. And we're going to start with right out of the gate, at the beginning of the race, Martin Truex Jr. blew a tire entering turn 3. He was off the pace prior to that, so you can tell the tire was about to let go. So that's our first playoff driver with an issue in today's race. Then restart at lap 10. And then green flag pit stops happened around lap 36 and lap 38. The pit window was a little bit later on, but Logano short pitted as a strategy thing. And it is a little quiet in here, so I'm going to turn on this fan here. Here we go. And then Austin Dillon spins and hits the wall in turn 2, as Byron spun out as well, kind of at the same time. And that, of course, bring out the caution. Then a fire breaks out in William Byron's pit stall during a caution. The pit gun emitted some sparks and it caught some of the fuel ablaze. But the fire was quickly extinguished, and I do believe the fuel the gas man was okay after that. Just some minor flames on his fire suit. So anyways, lap 70 is when the restart occurred. And Kyle Larson went on to win stage 1, scoring a playoff point. Stage winners always get a playoff point. So anyways, stage 2 begins at lap 88. And then our second playoff driver to have an issue, which was Bubba Wallace, who had a flat tire. So, suffering the same fate as Truex, unfortunately. Tough break for Wallace. He was one of my picks to win the race, considering he won last year's race at Kansas. So, tough break for Bubba Wallace. So anyways, the restart at lap 114. Then Austin Cindric spun off of turn 2 after being bumped by Michael McDowell. And then the restart at lap 20. And then something bizarre with Chase Briscoe's car. It shut off on him for some reason down the backstretch. So NASCAR threw the caution as a safety measure so he doesn't get clobbered. And then later on, Briscoe got the problem resolved. His car started back up and he was on his way. And then restart at lap 133, and Brad Keselowski won the stage. That will help him in the playoff run. Then the final stage began at lap 172. And then Harrison Burton hit the wall off of turn 2 and then cut a tire in turn 3 after contact with NASCAR Truck Series playoff contender Carson Hocevar driving the 42 car. Harrison Burton's damaged vehicle policy clock expired, so he DNF'd. Then restart with 88 laps to go. And then more green flag pit stops around lap 214 and 216. And then our third playoff driver to have a flat tire to bring out the caution was Chris Buescher. So playoff implications for some of our playoff competitors. So page 2, it's just a little bit. It's just the tail end of the race, which resulted in overtime. And Tyler Reddick made a really great pass on the front stretch, passing both Eric Jones and Joey Logano to take the win at Kansas and advance into the round of 12, so he doesn't have to worry about Bristol. But for the drivers on the bubble, they have a lot of ground to make up, especially those who are below the cutoff. So congratulations to Tyler Reddick for getting 23-11 racing another win. This race was actually their 100th Cup Series race, so that was a pretty special win for them. Now to my personal thoughts on the race. This race had some flat tires, kind of reminded me of Bristol last year and Texas as well, where those races were plagued with tire issues, but this race could have been worse. But overall, pretty good race. We had some great battles, of course. Intermediate tracks have been pretty good with the next-gen car. So, pretty good race still. So anyways, that'll do it for this week's post-race thoughts and recap video. Make sure to stay tuned next week for the Bristol post-race thoughts and recap video. And also, a quick announcement regarding NASCAR Diecast Shenanigans 4. It is in development. It's in production, but I am missing a few cars for it, for some skits. So I have gotten a few skits done, but it's not 100% complete. I would say it's about 70 or 80% complete. So make sure to stay tuned for NASCAR Diecast Shenanigans coming soon. And also, of course, next week's post-race thoughts recap video at Bristol, the cutoff race for the round of 16. Four drivers will be eliminated, of course. So anyways, that'll do it for this week's post-race thoughts recap video. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.